Well, you know, it is officially training camp when Ian Rappaport is in town. And Ian, you have already had the opportunity to talk to Kevin O'Connell, Kwesi Adofo-Mensah, even some of the players. Walk us through, first and foremost, why you're out here, and two, what have those conversations been like?
Yeah, I think for me, you know, what I want to do is go out to the camps, either have a new staff or a new quarterback or a place I just haven't been in a while, and just get some information and just kind of see what's going on. And I think for me, you know, coming here and just checking in on the progress of J.J. McCarthy and just where this organization is something that it's important. And, you know, I think this is also a pretty enjoyable place to be. Kevin O'Connell is great. Kwesi is great. Always great catching up with those guys. So come out to training camp and just hang out for a little bit.
From those conversations, how would you assess where the Vikings are right now in the quarterback position?
I think they're in a really good place. You know, I wouldn't be surprised if it's Sam Darnold going out there and starting. I think that's, you know, most people's expectation. And I think that's great. That's a great place to be. You know, if that continues, unless JJ makes, you know, really, really, really hard push, I think that's perfect because, you know, Sam is for sure talented enough, for sure good enough to go out and play, good enough to go out and start this whole year. And the fact that he's going to get really, really good coaching, you know, certainly could help him reach the kind of heights that he's wanted to reach and paving the way for JJ. If JJ comes in and, you know, essentially demands to play with his performance, then okay. Yep. Then that's a great place to be as well, because that's going to happen eventually. It's just, you know, when does it actually happen?
And I think fans are, you know, excited about the possibility that what can be with JJ and Sam Darnold. But thinking about how the Vikings will attack it this offseason is going to be interesting. You've had those conversations. You'll be out here at practice. We were filming this prior to practice, so you'll be out here at practice. But from what you've heard from Brian Flores, how do you see the defensive side starting to mesh, giving some of the holes that they have?
Yeah, I mean, I think the defense is going to be really, really good. You know, I mean, look, I mean, could they use another corner? Probably. I think there's some places they could fill in some gaps. But, you know, also, like, this is why you draft. This is why you have young players. There's going to be someone who we haven't heard of or we don't know well is going to step in and emerge in a key role. I will say this. Talking to some of the offensive coaches, Brian Flores makes things as difficult as you could imagine for the offensive coaches. And so just the fact that they have to tell J.J. McCarthy, like, this is not normal, is a very good thing. I mean, Flo is going to throw it all at you. I think they have the talent to be really good, and yeah, I think that's what it should be.
Have you seen anything like that just in your time covering the league where a defensive coordinator would say, hey, look, here's how you can help dissect this? Like, have you ever seen that in your time?
Okay. I think when you have coaches who are good people, I think that sometimes happens, and it's really what you want. You know, and that's why I think you've seen around the league, I think the Rams just did it. There's a couple other examples where you have – defensive coordinators working with the offense just to be like, all right, if I was going against you guys, here's what I would attack. Here's where you're vulnerable. Like, that's sort of like counterintelligence is really important. And I think we're seeing it more and more in the league.
I love it. My final question for you is, looking at this NFC North picture, how do you see the Vikings being competitive, giving this new look team under Kevin O'Connell and Kwesi in year number three?
They should be competitive. They should be good. You know, is it going to be where they're going to be in like 3 years? Like, maybe not, you know, because I think for, you know, if you're J.J. McCarthy, like, you know, you're not going to be the best you are as a rookie, right? And I think this is a team, because you moved on from Kirk Cousins, it's not a rebuild because it's a really talented roster, but it's a little bit of a reboot. So if you have to take a small step back, or if a start is a little rough, or whatever it is, none of it matters if you have a franchise quarterback for the next 15 years. So it's a little bit of a transition year. But I think because they're talented, because they're coached well, I think they could be fine during it.
I love it. Like I always say every time we interview, it's been a pleasure being with the busiest man in showbiz. So, Ian, appreciate your time today.
Thank you, man. Thanks for having me.